We are back right now with a live look at Kennedy Space Center and Launch Pad 39A.
Crew 7's pre-dawn liftoff is on track for 3:50 a.m. in the early morning hours of Friday. West 2 Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler is keeping a close eye on the preparations.
That's right. He walks us through the importance of the science on board.
Dragon Crew Capsule Endurance atop a Falcon 9 rocket sits ready and waiting on Launch Complex 39A. Crew 7, four astronauts from four different space agencies. That's a first for the commercial crew program.
And I think shows the breadth of the cooperation around the globe.
You can probably tell from the huge smiles on our faces that we're extremely excited to finally be here at Kennedy Space Center.
Commanding is NASA's Jasmine Mokbeli. Danish astronaut Andreas Morgensen of the European Space Agency will serve as pilot. And mission specialist Russian Konstantin Borisov and Satoshi Furukawa from Japan. And heading up with them to the International Space Station, over 80 new science investigations, working those and hundreds others during their six-month stay. With focus on the impact zero gravity has on the human body, a study for deep space exploration.
We think about hazards like radiation and isolation. Microgravity is one of those big hazards, and so LEO, or Low Earth Orbit, and International Space Station is a fantastic analog for us to really understand what we need to be preparing for.
And there'll be a new facility used on this Crew 7 launch for the very first time. A new launch control center was just certified this week on SpaceX's Hangar X complex. The new center will allow all SpaceX and NASA commercial launch managers to be closer together than at the previous facility in the NASA LCC, now all in the same room.
They're amongst the team. It gets that same feel and a comfortable feeling for everybody to actually talk amongst themselves if we have to work any issues or look at anything particular when it comes down to the safety of the crew.
On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.